I'm not ready yet.
Hi, I'm Doug from the Internet's Film Geek Primer. I've just been watching 1982's Conan the Barbarian, and I think it's terrible. Whenever I come across a movie that seems to have a much better reputation than it deserves, that's when I bring it to my fellow geeks.
Conan is the brainchild of scribe Robert E. Howard, who created the character back in the early 1930s. A decent little biopic about Howard called The Whole Wide World was made back in 1996, and it starred Vincent D'Onofrio and Renee Zellweger.
The genre itself dates back to 2650 BC with the Epic of Gilgamesh.
How about we just stick with movies?
How about Harryhausen? Seventh Voyage of Sinbad in 1958?
Nothing earlier?
You've got Fritz Lang's Der Nibelung, 1924. For silent film.
We didn't need dialogue back then, we had faces.
Enough of the history. Conan seems to be the first sword and sorcery movie to take its subject matter with the utmost seriousness and abandon all of the fun swashbuckling that the previous films in the genre had.
All right, I'll give you that. Buckles were not swashed in that movie.
But why? Why remove the, how you say, fun?
The movie's intent was to present a realistic depiction of life in the Hyborian Age, as if Conan the Barbarian were a real person. Conan's funectomy was performed by writer-director John Milius and conspiratorialist-slash-auteur Oliver Stone.
The original script was over 300 pages long and included massive battles with monster armies and skeleton warriors!
Sounds like fun!
Had to go. Budget concerns for visual effects at the time made it pretty damn near impossible. Plus, Milius was worried that it would destroy the realism of the world that he was trying to create. He didn't want another Jason and the Argonauts.
Right. Too fun.
You know, I'm surprised that a guy like you who loves the Lord of the Rings trilogy so much couldn't get into Conan. I mean, come on, Rings is about as dry as day old Limbus bread.
I don't know. Maybe it was the massive battles with monster armies and skeleton warriors.
Yeah, but Conan battles a giant snake.
The Two Towers had dwarf tossing.
Conan punches a camel!
Gandalf was a pipe-weed-smoking wizard!
Conan was bred with the finest stock.
Sean Astin! He was in the Goonies!
Mako! Mako, Mako, Mako!
Focus!
John Milius, writer and director of The Superb Dillinger, The Deliciously Jingoistic Red Dawn, and The Utterly Forgettable Flight of the Intruder.
Rumor has it that he can tear a phone book in half, feasts off the corpses of transients, and once made love for 9 straight hours. To himself.
That's so crazy, it has to be true.
A good film geek has seen all the films of Oliver Stone. Platoon, Wall Street, JFK, even the extended director's cuts of Alexander, and the cinematic masterpiece, The Hand.
Together they made Conan the Barbarian.
A breath of fresh air to the sword and sorcery genre.
It's called halitosis.
This was the movie that really introduced mainstream audiences to Arnold Schwarzenegger. It would set up what would be his breakthrough role in The Terminator.
And the movie that gave him the world's best campaign slogan.
Crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and you hear the lamentation of the women.
But I find the films that it spawned more entertaining than the original film.
Do tell.
Beastmaster, Kroll, Dragon Slayer, I'll even give Hawk the Slayer a couple of points.
Hawk the Slayer was before Conan.
That's why it only gets a couple of points.
Hey, did you guys ever see Red Sonja?
I kinda liked it.
Alright, I'm getting into brass tacks here. What is it that makes you dislike Conan so much?
Maybe the music is too overbearing, maybe it's the lack of visual effects. Maybe countless hours of Hercules and Xena have diluted its impact. Maybe I just need to give it another try. Nope, just not impressed.
You're jaded. Recap.
The sword and sorcery movies can be traced back to the days of silent films and have had various resurgences in popularity over the years. Seventh Voyage of Sinbad in the 50s, Conan back in the 80s, and most recently, The Lord of the Rings.
John Milius, writer-director of 1974's Dillinger, starring Warren Oates, and 1984's Red Dawn, the first film to be released with a PG-13 rating. Milius also wrote the original screenplay for the classic Apocalypse Now. And for those of you who are high right now, it's rumored that Milius was the inspiration for Walter Sobchak, John Goodman's character in the Coen brothers' The Big Lebowski. Writer-director Oliver Stone has many noteworthy films. I'm going to name-check Salvador and Talk Radio because they don't seem to be getting much word of mouth these days. Also, he showed America that he could make fun of himself in the movie Dave.
Arnold Schwarzenegger appeared in the neither sword nor sorcery-related Hercules in New York, Bob Rafelson's Stay Hungry, and the wacky comedy western The Villain, prior to his breakout role in Scavenger Hunt. Conan the Barbarian.
Too serious-minded for its own good, Conan the Barbarian may have re-legitimized sword and sorcery movies in the 80s, but its more entertaining offspring such as Beastmaster, Kroll, and Dragon Slayer are a hell of a lot more fun.
Alright, so Dub, I have to ask, the inferior sequel, Conan the Destroyer, you liked it more?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Crom.
It's win-win.
I need a back arch. I'm Shatner vomiting. I don't really think Brigitte Nielsen deserves this kind of treatment.